how do you know if a relationship was toxic? Hey guys, Sarah K Ramsey here to help you find love and success after a toxic relationship. And I want to talk about, I don't know if it's really toxic, right? Because there's so many definitions and there's so many examples, and you go through a red flag list, and sometimes it's really obvious. You're always walking on eggshells, you're always, maybe they're very controlling, maybe they yell, maybe they throw things, maybe there's, some type of abuse present. It's really easy to gauge if the relationship is toxic. But other times, it's easy to hear other people's stories and say, well, mine's not that bad, so it must not have been toxic, right? And not that every relationship was toxic. I'm definitely not talking anybody into that. That would be crazy, because they're not. But I do want to, my hair's flying everywhere in the wind. I'm seeing it right now. I do want to help give you some information on that, right? And I want you to imagine a hot stove, okay? And there is, the other person is trying to put their hand on the hot stove. They are displaying characteristics that would get them in trouble for some reason, right? They couldn't treat a stranger like that. Or maybe they're lying, or maybe they are, have stuff to do with money, or maybe they, have a drinking issue, or maybe they get in trouble with things, or maybe they're irresponsible, or maybe they're not coming to work, and they're always trying to touch the stove. And in a normal situation, if you touch a stove, you get burnt, and you learn something. But in a toxic situation, so often, the partner or mother or whoever puts their hand in between the toxic person and the stove so that they don't get burned and they never learn from their actions. Okay? And when people talk about the term codependency, I really don't like that word in all circumstances, because I don't think it applies to all circumstances. And we talk about smart girl syndrome, we talk about loyalty, and talk about your kindness being used against you. I believe in all those things. But I think about codependency, and I think about someone should have learned consequences from their actions, like, hey, if you talk to people like that, they leave, or hey, if you lie about that, then you get caught, or hey, if you act angry, then there are consequences, right? But we slip our hands in between their hand and the stove so they never get burnt. The problem is when they don't touch the stove and they don't get burned, when they try to touch the stove and they don't get burned, they don't learn from what happened. And you are the one with burned hands. You are the one with scars on your hands. You were the one trying to take care of everything so that, that's what family does. That's what, you keep trying to clean up the messes or pretend the anger didn't happen. Okay? And you end up doing all the work of the relationship and taking responsibility for the relationship. And usually, they still say it's your fault. They still blame you, okay? But they never learn from their actions or learn because they never reap the consequences. If you yell at a stranger, they, and act badly, they cut you out of their life. Or, if you hit a stranger, it's assault. I don't like to talk about domestic violence that often here, but if you hit your wife, it doesn't count as much. You get a lot more trouble for hitting a stranger than for hitting And if you are constantly covering up an addiction, or constantly covering up their selfishness, or constantly covering up the fact that they're one person at home and one person in business, or one person in the world, they never feel the burn of the stove. So they never learn from their actions. And you are doing all that work, and then your poor hands are covered with scars trying to do the right thing, trying to help, thinking, oh, they'll learn next time. They don't learn because they don't get burnt. Okay? And there's two different pieces of papers, right? And this is with adult kids too, right? It's like, this is my problem, this is not my problem. This is my problem, this is not my problem. This is my problem, this is not my problem. And we start to get enmeshed with toxic people and feel like their problems are our problems, and us saving them from their problems is our problems. And that's where it gets really messy, and then you feel guilt, and you feel like you can't do anything about it, or, oh, they're my family, who would do that to their mother, who would do that to their adult child. But then behavior perpetuates and goes for years and years and years and years, because they never feel the pain of consequences person is always reaching on the stove, you know, always doing something that in normal circumstances wouldn't be okay, it's toxic. And if you are the one who's getting your hand burnt in hopes of helping them or trying to cover over them, then it's a toxic relationship to you. Have a great day. Hope that helps.